And we're off. Here is Oregon at the top right.
All right, Nick, do you think he'll play any differently? Considering they didn't even look at the replays for the first game, do you think he already knows in his mind what he did wrong? Or
yeah, you know, my guess is that he just knows he shouldn't have been sending these chunks of Medic Marine out early on. He didn't give him any map control. I will admit that the Zerg pretty much controlled the way that the Terran had to play the game, and basically Terran fell right into Zerg's hands, forcing the Terran to get a bunch of Wraiths and then just teching right to Ultralisks. Well, Wraiths are not going to do a whole lot against Ultralisks. Ultralisks might not be anti-air, but, I mean, Ultralisks are not going to be killed off very quickly by Wraiths, so having the lack of vessels makes the Ultralisks very strong. Now, this game, we may see our Terran player be more aggressive, but this is also a map that favors macro for both races in this matchup. Although, you know, being a former, I still am a competitive player, but I mean, I've been to a lot of StarCraft tournaments in my life. I know what it's like when you just know that you just play terribly in a game, and it's very difficult sometimes to get your mind back in that set where you just want to, everything's going smoothly.
Right.
Because I think Terran was just nervous, but moving out like that, and then, you know, there were just two moments. And then we attacked, there were, maybe 9 sunken colonies, and he just sent everything in there.
That was pretty sloppy of him.
I think so.
Even I was able to notice that one, Nick.
I think he was just nervous. I mean, that's my guess.
I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, a lot of players who don't do televised matches, even though you may be thinking, yeah, they're in a booth, nobody's watching, you know, they're just kind of sectioned off to themselves. No, a lot of the times I hear backstage how nervous they get. I've seen kids cry, you know, when I'm back there trying to do interviews, or it really affects their gameplay.
Yeah, absolutely. I've even seen people who throw up before tournaments because they're just so stressed out and, you know, they put so much pressure under themselves. And then there are players who are so calm and collected.
Like calm.
Oh, that wasn't even intentional by me. Yeah, exactly. And, you know, they're able to just remain composed. And, you know, it helps them out a lot. Now, it doesn't look like our Terran player is going to be too aggressive, at least early on. There is a special build order that you can do that was pretty popular. I know Flash liked to do it a lot, where he would make his supply depots and barracks on the low ground. And then they would do a type of, somewhat of a rush, and then back off and fast expand. And it was pretty strong. It doesn't seem to be that common anymore. And in this case, it's actually the Zerg who's going to be a little bit more aggressive, forcing the Terran to put some SCVs at the ramp. We may see Terran make a command center pretty soon here. We don't see a second barracks up just yet. And Zerg, I think in the early mid-game, we're going to see Zerg really focus on economy. We see 2 hatcheries, with 2 extra hatcheries besides the main one, which are going to both the expansions, which are readily available. So there might be a little bit of downtime here, just briefly, where they attempt to build up their economy and attack. And we can see the scouting SCV. Still managing to stay alive. The layer should start probably in under a few seconds. And he wants to keep that SCV alive to see if his opponent's going to get the den or the spire. Now you can see Terran's playing cautiously. Terran didn't opt to construct the barracks the command center on the low ground. And instead, he's going to float it over there. Now that means he loses a few seconds. And how soon that expansion could be up, but he knows the Calm is pretty aggressive, and because of that, he wants to play it safe. And, you know, right now, Zerg is going to keep these Zerglings outside of the Terran base. He wants to spot when the Terran leaves so he can make his sunken colonies at the last possible second. And, yep, second extractor comes up here. And Terran's going to attack to the Medic Marine. and eventually push out. We may see the Terran move out here in a minute or two and just force the Zerg to make sunken colonies and then move back. Because, you know, the Zerg, they make all of their buildings from drones, which could be used for mining. So if you force them to make extra sunken colonies that won't come in to be too handy, especially if you never bother to attack them, then you really hurt their economy later on. Uh-oh. Looks like Calm upgraded Zergling speed. That means he really does not want to let the Terran do any scouting whatsoever. Oh, this fly. This fly is flying around me, man.
I was going to say, I'm thinking Calm really knows what he's doing right now. He seems very confident in his play.
Yeah, Calm seems to be... Well, he seems to know exactly what he's doing.
He's definitely got control from what I'm getting a feel from right now.
And, you know, he's going to get that Spire up. And he's going to go for the Mutilus Harassment again. You know, some of the Zerg players I know, they say that if they know that their opponent's nervous or uncomfortable, they'll almost always tech to Mutilus because the players... They feel so nervous that it's hard to micro their Medic Marine when it's, you know, very stressful when Mutilisks are flying around at your base. So he might just be doing that again. Or this may be the standard build that he wanted to do on this map. You can see he scanned just there. He spots the Spire, so the turrets should be starting any second now. So should the Mutilisks. I don't know why he hasn't started making the Mutilisks. It's been like 3 seconds now. There we go. Well, the turrets should start any second. There's the first one. In the last game, the Mutilus Harassment wasn't incredibly effective, but it was more the Terran killing himself by sending out these units. You can see, he slipped two Zerglings in there. He's going to take out these entities, making the turrets help delay the turrets by a few seconds, and seconds really matter in a game like StarCraft. If you get those turrets up like 2 seconds too late before they're all finished, the Mutilus can start to pick off the remainder of the turrets, and then it just becomes a snowball effect where suddenly the Mutilus are too powerful, and it looks like that might be happening right now. Oh, this is bad. This is bad news.
Ben, I really think Calm was able to sense his opponent. After that first game, he just kind of knew how to play the second one.
Oh, definitely. You can see now he has this little hole where he can harass with the Mutilisks. Now, we'll see if he starts making Zerglings or if he techs to the Hydralis Den or if he does that unorthodox Greater Spire build. Whoa. Those guys all died at once. Right now, he's going to force the Medic Marine into different positions, find a weak spot, and then rush in there. And he is making Zerglings, which means he's going to be really aggressive here. He's going to maybe pull the Medic Marine into the back of the Terran base and then rush in here. Or he could throw the Zerglings away, one of the two. And taking a look over here, Zerg's economy is fantastic. This is pretty much what it's supposed to look like at this point in time. But we'll see if Terran actually manages to get out of his base here. Once again with the medics.
Actually, pretty funny you just said that, because as soon as you said it, I heard it again in Korean.
Oh, really?
Let's see if the Terran can get out of his base. Now, that just shows you, you know, Nick, you're a great caster. You know, when I hear what you say, I hear it again in Korean, like almost a split second after you say it. And I want people to know that you know what you say is pretty much on par with what the Korean commentators do say.
Thank you. That's very flattering. I think I don't think the Terran's going to actually be able to do anything with this Medic Marine Army. I think if we're going to see the exact same thing happen last game that we saw this game.
Yeah.
I could be mistaken. I don't know. I mean, it's a sizable army, but I have an inkling that, he's going to be able to pick off enough Medic Marines with the big god, yeah. And then when the lurkers come out here, he's going to come in at just the right angle.
Here we go.
This is going to be bad.
This is going to be bad.
This could be brutal.
He's surrounded, huh?
Well, he could go out the back, maybe, but I don't know. See, the problem with when Terran does this is that you know, once they leave their base, you know, that Terran are not very mobile. Medic Marine are slow, you know, and you don't have unlimited stims. Those medics don't have a ton of energy. So, you know, you got to be careful. If you're leaving your army out there like this, there's always the possibility that Zerg will just get enough units and close in, and then you have no control of the game at all for a while. Okay, here it comes. Let's see if he can pull up. I don't think Terran's paying attention. Oh my god. That was bad. Whoa. His whole life just flashed before his eyes, I think. That was not good. Okay, well, I don't think Terran's gonna win now because he's not gonna be able to get out of his base. Zerg's got a lot of hatcheries. This is ridiculous. All right, well, he's going to try again. And, man, Zerg is just dominating. This is ridiculous.
This is going exactly to plan. I feel like he made Oregon pull out way too early.
Yeah, I think so. Well, you know, when you're playing against Zerg players, It's really uncomfortable when you see that they're expanding so much, they're taking so much of the map, that sometimes they push out too soon. By the way, fun fact, the positioning, the reason why he's putting the lurkers there is it's actually harder to see the lurkers on that texture that they're on right now. So sometimes if Terran's not looking carefully, they might just walk right into that. That's a common trick. Another common trick with lurkers is that these players will burrow them like behind trees, behind the doodads on the map, so that the Terran player doesn't spot them and then walks right into them. Let's see if he spots it here. Oh, he spots it.
Oh, wow.
Now this part's going to come down to micro. In this matchup, both the players' armies die very, very quickly. So if Terran micros perfectly, this game could completely turn around. I think Zerg needs to get a little bit closer to that army. Either that or he needs to counterattack the main. One of the two. I think he's going to go for the main. Looks like Terran may be prepared.
The Hydralisks are on the way, and...
Oh, God. Here it comes. It's going to be like that scene in Starship Troopers. Oh, what are these Marines doing? All right, here we go. Big attack. He's going to throw right next to the tanks. The vessel going to go down. Totally annihilated. Oh, my God, there are lurkers everywhere. This guy is good with lurkers, too.
Oh, there will be no Starship Troopers, too.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see if we have round three of Terran getting owned. And just like the last game, a dropship comes out way too late that will probably not inflict any damage. Even neutral buildings are getting a beating in this game.
And comes all over this. Literally, look at this map. He's all over this.
He's all over this. This map is red. This map matches us right now. Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, this could not get any worse. And now this is the part where he gets the Defiler and he covers the base with orange clouds and goes in there and wins the game. Here we go. Expect a game any second. There's just nothing Terran can do. And once the Lurkers get in range of the SCVs, it's going to be GG time. Yeah, this is it. Wow, Calm just plays so effectively. I'm so impressed.
He just read his opponent quite well.
Yeah. Uh-oh. You don't always get to see Defilers get killed by mines. My God. His macro is so good. Here we go now. Okay, this is... Okay, I'm actually, you know, to be honest, I'm a little surprised. Terran hasn't left already. And yeah, this that will definitely not help the tear in all those units. So, should probably leave, I think. I don't know. The command center's going to go down. Once he gets to the barracks, it's literally physically impossible to win. He's pretty much there. There it is.
There it is. GG. Play StarCraft as much as you do, Nick. Even I was able to see that Zerg player really had the upper hand. He knew exactly what was going on.
Yeah.
He knew his opponent. He just, wow.
Yeah, that was very, it was a very one-sided game, I think.
I think so, too. The entire time, I mean, he roared out his opponent when, you know, when he knew he wasn't ready, obviously. That was just, am I allowed to say this? That was real.
That was just total ownage.
Pretty much was.
Just, there was really very little Terran could do. Terran wasn't actually bad. Don't get that impression, but Zerg was just very, very good.
Absolutely.
And I think the big mistake was Terran was just pushing out at these improper times. He should have been scanning maybe to see how many drones his opponent had to figure out, okay, how much is my opponent actually focusing on units versus economy? And, yeah, he just left his base at inappropriate moments and would get surrounded and killed. And, you know, if you lose a battle like that and your opponent doesn't lose any units, then you get so far behind. And, I mean, that happened twice.
Yeah.
And then, okay, it's like, well, what is he going to do? It just doesn't even matter if your opponent is microing well or not, because there's just too many units.
Yeah, I think Oregon was being a little sloppy. I mean, there was that time where he just left his Marine Medic standing there, you know, and he's starting to get attacked, and you just saw them standing there still. And so those little mistakes really cost him the game.
Yeah, I agree completely. Well, coming up next, we're going to have Hero versus Barrix. Susan, tell us a little bit about Hero and Barrix.
All right, well, Hero, he is 22 years old. He is a We Made Fox player. And so in my notes here, I'm just saying, well, let's see, you know what, he struggles a lot in the major leagues. He was actually pretty good, again, another really good B-team kind of member. He did well in the MSL Survivor, etc. He's known to have pretty good build order, but he's really weak with mechanics. So, you know, he tends to make some questionable decisions time to time, and it could be because he gets nervous again on televised games. And it's so common with these players, especially at this level, because as we know, we're doing the round of 128. Many of these guys don't get to be on TV.
Yeah.
And so this is a big deal to them. And
that's a whole other animal to master. You know, playing in front of people. I mean, I've been at LANs and had a lot of people watching me play, and it feels very different. And I'm sure it's even more different when you're playing in a booth and everybody can see your screen and watch exactly what you're doing. I mean, that's got to be quite...